my sword. Slow-mo.
Stop it! You don't cut it like that, you stupid bitch! Hiya, Keith Taylor here, and you've joined me live in Doreen's Country Kitchen. Now, Doreen, as you know, is a mocky bastard, but she's quite a talented cook. We're here in a country kitchen, and we're going to have a look at some professional cookery tips, courtesy of Doreen Peacock. Now, you're probably wondering, well, how come Doreen, all of a sudden, is peeling parsnips, when the last time we seen her, she was peeling Keith Taylor's crack and sack? Well, that's because she got the sack for using the wrong sort of wax, and was using earwax instead of the aloe vera. Weren't you bad?
Yeah.
All right. So, come on in. You love going at a distance, don't you, Julia? Now, talk us through what you're doing here, Doreen.
Well,
all right, Doreen, don't go on. Now, Doreen, show us some of the utensils. Utensils, what you're using.
Well, we've got a
fucking hell, Doreen.
It's very sharp, though.
The fucking samurai sword. What are you paying for?
Those are quite blunt.
Fucking knob. So, what are you cooking?
So, we're going to have a soup. So, what I'm doing is
soup.
Peeling the parsnips. And then we don't use that.
I see, I don't know why people watch. Can you see the people that sit watching the cookery programmes of a Saturday? I couldn't think of anything more fucking boring than sitting there watching some twat cooking and then, well, some other twat cooking. Just cook it yourself. Learn. What else are we having? What are you having for the main?
Well, we've got a leg of lamb in there.
Huh? Can you get in there, Julian?
Turn that
fucking hell, it's like Hansel and Gretel's bloody oven, that is, isn't it? Can you see? Could you even see?
No. Half a child in there.
Well, there's a lamb in there, a whole one, still fucking bleating, I think. And,
I'm
not sure yet, we'll come back to him.
We'll come back to that.
Right, and then for the pudding, it looks like we're having rotten apples. Mm.
Well, that'll make a crumble. Cut the bruising off.
Joking, aren't you? All the cutting the bruises off, there's nothing left but cores. The cores. Hello! Anyway, we'll see you in a bit because we're going to go for a walk in a bit. Fuck knows why. Bastard raining, so I'm Poland out there. Ta da!
For me? Do you want to put it on? I tried it on as she was like that.
So if you're wondering why we're all dressed like fucking idiots, it's because Doreen's decided that it'd be nice for us to go for a walk. Despite the fact that it's pissing down and it's cold. And I don't like to walk because I have someone to drive me around.
And he doesn't have his chafing pants on him.
You watch your mouth, Doreen.
His chafing pants.
Anyway, there better be a bloody good pub on the way. Come on, everyone, let's get the fuck out of here.
The footage of the beautiful scenery.
I mean, words cannot describe just how disappointing it is here. I was told we'd come to the seaside, but all I've seen so far is rain and dog shit. And quite frankly, it weren't worth a 4-hour trip. So don't come here. It's shit. So, you might not be aware, but in time for Christmas, I'm putting together a photo catalogue of glamour shots. And here's a few of some of the best ones so far. So now we're trying to find a pub. But I'm not. We're not doing so well, are we, Julian?
No. We'll have that for dinner. We'll put it in the soup.
What the fuck's that?
It's vegan roadkill.
Fucking vegans. Now get on my tits. Everything's got to be for vegans now, isn't it? Well, I tell you what, the best thing they need is a fucking piece of carpet and like it. It's a fucking bastard. It's got to be vegan this and gluten free that. Come round to my house, I'll rub you in peanut butter and give you a slice of bread. Now fuck off. It's fucking freezing, Doreen.
It's brisking.
Brisking. Oh yeah. Now here we are on West Twatting Beach, just outside Cuntington. And we've come to pick a new house for Doreen to live in. Now, Doreen, which one do you like the best?
I like the colour scheme on this one here.
Number 12. It's
very beachy.
Yeah. These are hooker huts, by the way. This is where all the hookers from Twattington live. And you pick a ticket, and then your ticket corresponds to the slag. What is in the den? What is in the hut here? So, Doreen used to live in number 13, which certainly was unlucky for some. Now, obviously this isn't the place you'd bring the family for an all-inclusive, because not just because it's fucking horrible and freezing and wet, but because people what live here are fucking stupid. I mean, look at this. I mean, call me a novice, but I thought the concept of fucking boating was that you put the boat in the water, not the water in the fucking boat.